Now to tonight's special report. New documents obtained by the ABC from the archive of NSA whistleblower Edward Snowden reveal the Pine Gap surveillance base in Central Australia plays a crucial role in US military action around the world. The information reveals that the Joint Defence Facility at Pine Gap tracks mobile phones and email traffic to locate targets anywhere in the world. This exclusive report from Peter Crono.
Pine Gap is a joint US-Australian facility run primarily by America's National Security Agency, with a staff of 800, half of whom are Australian. Top secret documents obtained by the ABC's background briefing program now provide the first clear proof that this surveillance site is crucial to US military operations in the battlefield. One document, titled NSA Intelligence Relationship with Australia and marked Top Secret, describes the facility, known under the NSA codeword Rainfall, as a site which plays a significant role in supporting both intelligence activities and military operations.
These documents show us that Pine Gap is critically not just a part of a strategic intelligence organisation at the national level, the things you might tell the president. These are things that you'll tell the majors and captains in companies and battalions on the ground in operations. This is extraordinarily important for the United States in military terms today.
Professor Richard Tanter is the foremost researcher in Australia on the functions of the Pine Gap base. He says the base used to provide mainly high-level strategic intelligence about other countries, but that's now changed.
It certainly makes us not only legally complicit, but morally.
The base is linked to huge satellites that suck up vast amounts of digital data from electronic sources, including mobile phones, email accounts, and internet connections. Pine Gap looks north and west. The NSA's Menwith Hill base in the UK looks south and east so that together most of the Earth's landmass is covered. Analysts at Pine Gap can find a target by seeking the signals and location of their communications, like mobile phones, and then firing that information via optical cables to military centres in the US. From there, it can be sent to commanders in the battlefield or to the pilots of the US's expanding fleet of lethal unmanned drones based in Nevada.
I think any country that has a cable, a satellite, a connection to this remote war, no matter what that connection is, I just think it's wrong.
After working as a technical sergeant on the US drone program, Lisa Ling resigned from the US Air Force and twice traveled to Afghanistan.
I went back to see the people, to see the humanity. There's so much distance that's created with the drone program that it's just too easy to forget that these are real people and families with children.
The US has been accused of killing hundreds of civilians in its decades-long drone wars. But David Rosenberg, a 23-year veteran of the NSA and former senior Pine Gap official, says the operations at the base help prevent civilian casualties.
The intelligence that Pine Gap collects would certainly be used to help to minimize any kind of loss of life. The information provides additional intelligence to the United States, to Australia, to whoever might be involved on the ground.
But Richard Tanter questions the legality of Pine Gap's role in supporting US military operations.
There's something wrong with an unseen object in the sky killing somebody on the ground in a country with which we are not at war.
However, David Rosenberg says Australia's role at Pine Gap is legitimate and essential in the war on terror.
The tasking that's given to Pine Gap is simply to passively intercept electronic signals. The intelligence from that, of course, is then sent back to the requesting agency, the analysts, to act on that kind of intelligence.
Some believe Australia's contribution at Pine Gap is an important part of its alliance with the US.
It's something which, frankly, saves us a great deal of money, because if we were forced to do everything that the alliance provides by ourselves, you could easily double the Australian defence budget.
For some observers, that's not enough.
Pine Gap, if it was to have any legitimacy at all, must be completely refigured on the basis of principles and law. And that's something that's going to be very hard for Australian government to deal with.
Pine Gap has really been regarded as the jewel in the crown of Australia's intelligence cooperation with the United States. And what it does is provide us with a wealth of intelligence information which is relevant to how Australia thinks about its security.
The public needs to speak out. We need to ask for transparency. And we need to ask to have some real discourse about what is going on in these wars.